Krishna sees who is qualified to receive my mercy and who is not. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu does not see. He accepts everyone who comes to him. Uttama adama kinchana bachala jachya dileka ko kahe prema gando.
Try to prepare more for tomorrow. Give it to Arjuna.
Venu Gopal.
Lalit Mohan.
Lalit Mohan. She is not here. How do you explain?
Om Gyanati Vrindasya Gyanati Nashalakriya Chakshudhu Nirtangyena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah.
Not so much.
So, Lochan Das Thakur is writing in this beautiful bhajan that we should take advantage of this wonderful opportunity that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving us. That once in a day and night of Brahma, that means once even more every 8 billion years, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes into this world to spread such wonderful tidings, and that tiding is that with just his mercy and the mercy of Nityananda Prabhu, we are able to understand, and with Gurudev's mercy, able to comprehend and practice, as Madhav Prabhu was saying, Unat Ujvala Ras Bhakti Shriyam, that is the beauty of the love of Srimataji for Krishna. So Lochan Das Thakur is also very munificent, and he's inviting us all to the bathing place of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because at this place there is a ferry boat. And in this ferry boat, we can all the blind, the lame, those who have no qualification for this bhakti, are actually able to board the boat. And by the mercy of the Guru as the helmsman, the favorable winds are of prem, and the and Harinam Sankirtanam, for this age of Kali, Harinam Sankirtan is the way by which we understand Krishna. So he's saying that raising our hands in the air and singing these beautiful kirtans and chanting Haribo Haribo, that our hands are actually the oars, and we will row across by feeling bliss in sankirtan. So he's inviting all of us to chant the names of Gaurhari, and with the by the mercy of Srila Gurudev and by the mercy of the Vaishnavs, from this side of this. In this world of suffering, we will very easily be row across to the side to Vrindavan, past Vaikuntha, past Ayodhya, past Dwarka, past Mathura, and we will be rowed into Braj.
This song?
No.
Vatvatvali?
No. I think it's there in.
It just will try to explain the words.
The words only.
Not Ajodhya Dwarka Mathura.
Namam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Shami Niti Namire
Bhakti
Maya Bhutale Shri Shri Maan Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Tina Nitananda Shri Adaita Gadadhara Shri Vasari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Come on here. Any beautiful sound? This will come here. Don't be late.
Oh,
Thank you.
something. Two lines go down and two lines high. Then it will be more sweet. Like this. First down and then two up. Up. Like you should do. Do Kirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. The same line. You should do. Hare Krishna in this thing.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Go down, sir. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare,
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare,
Hare Rama Hare Rama, Rama Rama Hare Hare,
Hare Rama.
Gaur Praman, Dande Hari Hari Bo. You come? Here? How you jumped here?
Mercy of the Supreme Lord.
Oh, you jump? Will you finish this? Finish this? Although you should not jump others, you should have the honor for superiors. No? This, we should learn to give respect to senior devotees of Swamiji. So you should go there and here. Understand me?
You should give some respect to those who are senior. Just as if you sit somewhere.
Oh, there? You have any questions?
Any questions
you have? You should go and give. Oh, there are so many seniors. Like they are, I honor them, but they are so humble that they are sitting there. You should be humble so much and give so much honor to seniors. Then you can go up. You should learn, all should learn. At the time of taking prasadam, at the time of also kirtan, at the time of sitting anywhere, we should try to always give honor to all. In the morning, when we are doing parikrama, senior should go forward and junior gradually. Not to disturb anyone. Not to disturb. Always keeping onward. If you are not giving honor and you are not humble, you cannot progress. Juniors should also give honor and seniors. they will teach them with, oh, like son, like your not brother, with love and affection. But they should be taught all these rules and regulations. Always try to respect seniors, always. But seniors should see also that if anyone being shishya of shishya, but he has so much in what? No. If he is qualified, he has given all his worldly things and he knows all the transcendental truths, practicing bhakti yoga, and he is serving so much Vaishnava and Guru, then he should also respect him. All this. Not gathering. In this way, we can increase all this. You know, Swamiji preached everywhere in the world. Pujya Vasudeva Maharaj was sitting in Navadvip. And how he used to give him honor, you know? Now disciples perhaps not knowing because they are concealing these facts. He has so much honor for my Gurudev. So much. So he is seniors always, like Siksha Guru. Like I honor my God brothers, like my Siksha Guru, to become Maharaj, Brahman Maharaj, to others, they are very senior. They respect so much, but I always give. So, Pujya Pas, Swami Maharaj was in the line of Vaishnava, Guru. So he must respect, he used to give respect to Pujya Parsidhar Maharaj, Bhakti Lastik Maharaj and all others. So we should know all the etiquettes. This is Vaishnava etiquette.
Abhyana Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitangina tasmai Shri Gurave Vanchakalpatarubhyasya Kripasindhubhyayvacha Patitanam Pamanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Mahabhadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayaya Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namne Gaurave Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhakta Tadabhaktaya Yam Prabhrijantamanupetamapetakrityam Dvaipayano Virahakataraya Jivam Utreti Tanmetaya Tarvo Vinedi Tang Sarvabhutaridayam Munimavatis Tavai vasmi, tavai vasmi, najvam tvaya vina, iti vigyai rade tam nena.
You know, Sanatana Goswami, also you have perhaps heard the name of Jagadananda Prabhu. Jagadananda Prabhu from boyhood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was in Navadvip Leela also. And he was like Satyabhama, having some man. So, Sanatana Goswami was the Prime Minister of any Muslim king. And he was so intelligent, learner of all Shastra. In Puri once he came, and then he met with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And then he returned to Vrindavan. Jagadananda was there. He wanted to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He wanted to serve so much. Sometimes anyone brought a vessel of, full pot of very fragrant Ayurveda oil. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sometimes he used to faint in Krishna consciousness. So he brought with great care. He gave it to Govinda that, you should put on the head of Mahaprabhu some oil daily. Then Govinda told to Mahaprabhu that Jagadananda has ordered me to give put some oil on your face. This is Ayurvedic, very powerful, like medicine. Mahaprabhu told very humbly that take this oil to Jagannath temple and give it to for lamp. So he could not put the oil on the head of Mahaprabhu. Next day, Jagadananda asked to Govinda that, have you put this oil on his head? He told us, I could not. Why? He ordered me to give this oil to Jagannath. And by thus, I will have that thing. He became very upset. And he took that oil pot and in the front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu he smashed. And all water, oil here and there. And he became so angry. And he went from there. He went to his bhajan koti and he locked the door. How are you? He said. Lock. Anyhow. One day, 2 days, he was crying. But not coming to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu thinking that, he has some anger to me because I am not accepted. And that is why he has. One day, third day. Then on fourth day in morning he went. And he knocked the door. Jagdananda. But he was not replying, only weeping. Mahaprabhu told that, for 3 days I have not taken anything. Empty stomach. And now I am so much hungry. I am going to take bath in ocean. And very soon I am coming. Be prepared all kinds of preparations for me. And telling him, went away. And he went to sea and took bath. And he again returned after 1 hour. In the meantime, Jagadananda, he took bath, changed his clothes, and then began to prepare so many kinds of vegetables, rice, dal, chapati, and so many things. Chutney of tamarind. There's so many things. About more than 56 more times. And he brought a very big banana leaf. 2, 3. And he preparation. Govind was with Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu told, he requested Govind that tell Mahaprabhu to take prasadam. Mahaprabhu told that, I cannot take. There should be 2 seeds and 2 leaves. And I will sit with Jagadananda. And we will take prasadam together. And if he is not taking, then I am going. Empty stomach. Then Jagadananda told to, not directly telling okay. to Mahaprabhu.
Not direct talk.
He told to Govinda. Govinda tell Mahaprabhu that he should take gladly. And after that, when he will finish, then we will both take together remnant of Mahaprabhu. Then he told to Mahaprabhu, you should take, he will take after you. So only remnant he will take. Then Mahaprabhu took prasadam. And then after that, that remnant was divided into two.
You don't know.
Then he became happy. But he was not coming directly to speak Mahaprabhu anything. Even there was some smell of mud. He went again after 2-3 days to Mahaprabhu and told that, I'm going to Vrindavan. Please order me. I want your permission. Mahaprabhu said, why you are going? For so many long time I wanted to go with you, but you could not take me with you. So now I want to go and to take darshan. I want to be there and to serve Radha Krishna Kanyuga. Mahaprabhu told, you can go, but not for
long time.
Go and see and return back. Don't climb on the top of Govardhan. You are not qualified to be there. You can quarrel there. You can see the rules and regulations. Yeah, Brajvasi is not taking bath or what he is doing. So then you will judge according to your mentality. So you make some offenses. So don't be there. You should return back. He went anyhow. But when he left Puri and he came to border under a tree, then he was lamenting so much. Why I did so mistake? I cannot be life without Mahaprabhu. I have done wrong. Should I go return? But how can I return? Then what will I answer? And he was in dilemma. What to do, not to do. One day, 2 days, he was there, weeping. Anyhow, he consoled his mind. Anyhow, I should go. Then he went to Vrindavan. And he met Sanatana Goswami. Sanatana Goswami told that you should be here and see with me all the past and places. One day, Sanatana Goswami was out of his bhajan kuti and he was cooking. He never took any madhukari. But I am not qualified for madhukari. Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, they are qualified. I cannot digest. We cannot digest madhukari. We are not qualified. So he was there and cooking. And what became? Sanatana Goswami took any saffron cloth from anyone. And he did like this. And he returned. Then he was cooking. And the pot was one on fire.
Stove.
It was so hot. It was khichdi. It was doing takbak. Takbak, you know?
Boiling.
So Sanatana Goswami, he asked Sanatana Goswami, you are very faithful to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. From where is this collected, this cloth of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? He told simply that it is not of Mahaprabhu, it is of any Mayabadi here. And he gave me and I took. Of Mayabadi, he at once took that pot and he... Then Sanatana Goswami became very humble and he was just smiling and telling, I was testing you. I know that you have so much faith on Mahaprabhu. So much faith. And you cannot wear any others, the saffron clothes of Mayavadi. You are so attached to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu repeats you, what is it meaning? He loves you so much. So he gives you Madhurya Ras of rebuking. And to me, Sanatana Goswami tells, Sanatana Goswami is so honorable person. He is so high class of devotee. He is superior to all. So this is like Nimbaras. Nimbaras, the juice of Nimbaras. When Sanatana Goswami was in Puri, and Sanatana Goswami was feeling himself that I'm so low, I'm so wretched person. He has some itches coming in the way, some mosquitoes has gotten, so much juice from his body was coming. Pus, very bad smelling. And Mahaprabhu, what he used to do? To embrace him. And Sanatana Goswami Yogi said, don't touch Prabhu. Then Sanatana Goswami met with Jagdananda and told, what should I do? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always wants to embrace me, and I'm so wretched, and this disease, and what's coming, and Mahaprabhu touches me. What should I do? Should I return to Vrindavan? Yes, you should go to Vrindavan. Don't be here. Otherwise, Mahaprabhu will touch you and he may have some disease, so you should quickly. Mahaprabhu heard this and told to Jagadan, oh, Jagai, you are a boy of only 2 days and you are being instructor of Sanatana Goswami. How he is superior? And you have dared to give some intelligence and advice. Don't think you like that you are so of 2 days only, boy only, having no intelligence. He gets that we should honor, especially those who are pure devotees, they should be humble and try to give honor to others. This is only way to progress in Krishna consciousness. Now we should come to our point. Oh, now it is 7. Come to with me in Vrindavan or Mathura. We concentrate your minds, no? You know that all the human beings in the whole world, even you are in America, the richest person now a days in the whole world, and you are making so much money, your house is full of all kinds of comforts and everything. Very, very beautiful wife you have. And when she becomes of 1 year, 2 years, you can divorce and again you pick up. And very good children qualify. Everything is okay. Having 2, 3, 4, 5 dogs, no harm. So you. But even there are so many problems. All are suffering. Especially those who are rich, more suffering than even. So in this world, anyone is not happy. And this life is full of miseries, problems, difficulties, sorrow, suffering. oldness also, and so many things. Rogues, full of rogues, diseases. In this world there is none who has never tested any kinds of suffering, sorrows or problems. I think among you there are so many rich persons. But any of you can raise hand that I have never had any problem without problem and I am always all time I am happy. Can anyone tell? Oh, today in morning you are telling that I am sick. I remember. So, in this world, there are none. Whether he can be king, prime minister, president, or anything. Only if there is surrender to Krishna, he may be happy. But he will tell, I am not happy. He never will tell. What he will tell? Oh, very big problem. Why I am alive? Why I am not dying? There is no darshan of Krishna. So in this world, anyone is not happy. So all the jivas, they want happiness. There are so many sufferings, problems in this world, and all are unhappy. That is why all want pure happiness. But it is absurd in this Maya Sansara. In this material world, anyone can get happy. That is why all the Vedas has told, Sukham me bhuyat, Dukham me ma bhutat. All the Vedas are telling that we should always be happy. Always happiness comes to me. And suffering should not come. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, Karmanya Rahmananam Dukkhattai Sukhayaca Pashet Pakam Viparyasam Mithuni Charina. In whole world, all are trying to have happiness. They want to be happy. For this, they try themselves or mixing with wife and husband, sometimes whole family, sometimes like Sanyukta Rashtra, assembly of all the United Nations. They try, but they cannot check wars, they cannot check anything, because they are themselves having so many problems. If they have so many problems, how they can solve other problems? They cannot. So it is told that we are trying for happiness. But our sufferings are so strong. They come and they keep their fists on our head. And for sadly, what? We'll have to test. For sadly. We are bound to test them. Can you have any remedy to escape from old age? Never. From death? Never. So all want that I should be happy. But only wanting will do. All want. But all are dukhi, all are suffering. But it cannot be told that always they are unhappy and they have a piece of happiness. Oh, they have. But that is happiness is like a very little. And at once they pass. Again, second, always problems coming, suffering coming like waves. We say that, oh, this problem we will solve and we will be happy. In the meantime, you are saying, oh, more bigger problem. So we are bound to this.